We started this yesterday. And we covered this topic. So, what are communication skills? Suparna, what do you think? What are communication skills? What do you mean by communication skills?
For me, communication skill, because communication word is there that whatever I am telling to to my client, she or he will able to understand.
Absolutely.
The same thing for me.
Correct, correct. Rightly said, communication skills are essential part for the successful career of an individual, right? And you
Yes.
rightly mentioned this is something that you are talking to someone, you're speaking with somebody, and the other person is able to understand you,
Understand.
right? And vice versa. So this
Yeah.
is what effective communication means. So effective communication has a lot of advantages in every field, be it aviation, travel, tourism, customer service, and hospitality. And not
Yes.
even this, if you're working in an MNC, effective communication plays very, very important role. All right. And like Monica mentioned, like she wants to become a successful HR personnel, she has to communicate with a lot of employees in the firm, right? In a very effective manner that they should understand, because there are a lot of policy that HR has to make the employee understand, which they don't even know about, right? So even in that part, effective communication plays a very, very important role. And effective communication can easily reach to heights in personal and professional life. So if you are a very effective communicator, all right, so there is a lot of chance, there are a lot of chances for you to get promoted in that particular firm, right? Because you have to be like an outgoing person, a person who can communicate with anyone easily, right? So, and especially in today's competitive world, this is one of the quality that you need to possess, right? Effective communication skills, be it any field. So, what communication skills are? The communication skills means the way you share and express your feelings, right? And you tell your views to other to get connected with them. If you are an effective communicator, it will help the other person to accept your views and ideas, right? So, in short, you have to make sense whenever you are talking, right? And if you are not communicating well with anyone, this can lead to loss in business, loss in customer. Sorry about that. So, if you do not communicate with someone effectively, that may lead to loss of a very important customer and loss of business as well. Right? So, that's why communication plays a very, very important role in a personal and professional life. Right? Anything, any difference in thoughts, anything that you need to add, guys, please feel free. Okay? Anyone? Or I'll just move ahead. So we did this yesterday, which is the art of self-introduction, and we're gonna do it tomorrow as well. All you need to do is give your introduction as you're gonna give in front of the interviewer. All right. So this will be your first question when you will appear for any interview. Okay, first question. All right. That's why we have to pay more attention over here. Sometimes when you just give your self-introduction in a way, like in a good way, then the interviewer, they just, don't ask the next questions from you. Maybe just two or three more. So that's why we have to emphasize on the introduction part a little more, because this is always be the first question in an interview. All right. Now this is also done and the activity as well. Another most important thing is the effective listening skills. Okay, so communication skills and listening skills go hand in hand, right? So if you are communicating with the other person and let's say you are not listening to him or her, right? So this is not effective communication. Or if the other person is not listening to you, would would he be able to accept your ideas or accept your views? No, right? Because he's not even listening, right? So that's why effective communication cannot be done if there is no effective listening over there. So to improve your communication skills, you must learn to listen actively, okay? Basically, first you improve in yourself and do not think about the other person, okay? Be the change first, you know? Get that change in yourself first. So there is a very thin line between hearing and listening. You need to listen to someone, okay? Do not hear them. So when you hear, it's like you are just taking those words for that time, but you're not understanding anything. So that's why listening is the most important part. And effective listening gives you an advantage and makes you more impressive when you speak. It also boosts your performance. So for example, if somebody is talking in, like a person is talking in front of a few people and you are one of them, right? And you are not paying attention or listening to that person. What if that person asks you a question right away? And whatever you'll be talking will not make any sense, right? So that's why it is very important to listen to that person, okay? Just understand what he or she is talking about. But because then if they will ask any question, it will actually boost your confidence while talking. If you knew that what he was talking about, right? So this is how communication skills are really very important. Effective listening skills will help you discover your field of interest. All right. So this particular slide is like when you are in a group of people talking of multiple things, right? So discover your field of interest. Somebody talking about something which you are interested in. And maybe you just find out that this is something that you want to do. And this is and when you will figure it out, when you know what they are talking about, right? Grasp and understand the matter and or content. Whatever content is being taught over there, if someone is saying something about a particular topic, do try to engage with them. So if you get engaged, if you ask questions, at that point of time, you will understand better. So that's why I always ask you to make the session as interactive as possible, because if you don't ask any question, how would I be able to know if you guys are getting my point or not, right? But if you are asking something or if you are adding something to my presentation or the points that I'm telling you, then it would be like a conversation happening, not like a training happening, right? So I want it to be a conversation kind of session. More of a conversation, less of a training. Of course, I'm here to train you guys. I'm going to give you better understanding of like how to become a crew, how to crack the interview, right? But then you can also participate, because maybe you have something, some interesting point to add on over here, and I can follow with that, right? I'm open to learn, guys. Okay, so even from you, anyone, if you have any points, do let me know, all right? And we can even, if you want me to explain that, I can also paraphrase that for your better understanding, right? So be open to accept new ideas and information. So here I am giving you a lot of information about communication skills, about customer handling, about interview. Like, you need to be open to accept that, right? If you are not, then there is no point of having the training, right? Jot down and take a note of important points. As I mentioned yesterday and today as well, that it is very, very important to take handwritten notes. You can refer to them anytime. And since you have written them, you will be able to understand them anytime in your life if you want to go through it again, right? Work upon listening, analyze and evaluate the speech in spare time. So this is how you need to work upon your listening. What you can do is watch videos, watch movies, English, Hindi, I would suggest English core. Then only you will work upon your listening skills, right? It's okay if you are watching them with subtitles on, up to you. But start watching short videos. If you are not fond of films, short videos would do. We have a lot of documentaries, even related to aviation. Watch that, right? Rephrase and summarize the speaker's ideas. So for example, you are in a meeting right now, right? And if your team leader, let's say, is talking about the performance, maybe asking about your ideas and making the team performance better. Always, always, after getting your turn, after talking all about your points, always rephrase and summarize. Okay. Summarize about not just what you have said, also about what the speaker has mentioned. All right. Ask questions. Very important. If you have any doubts, do ask questions. There are no stupid questions in the world. All right. If you do not understand anything, it's okay. It's absolutely fine. All right. Avoid distractions. So like avoid going in your own Dala land if somebody is talking. Right. Always pay attention over there. Do not think about something else in the back of your mind. Otherwise, you will miss out on some statement or some word which can actually ruin the discussion on your part. Right? Any doubts, any questions in that? Good?
No, Miss Neha, no doubts.
Okay. But you guys are getting me, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Is it simple?
Yeah, it is simple. That's why I'm understanding it easily.
Yeah. Because this is how I've made this presentation simple and with the point so that it is easy for you to understand.
To understand, yeah.
Right, yeah. You can take screenshot if you want, but if you want to jot down important points, do it yourself. It is good to have handwritten notes, right? Now, characteristics of an effective listener. So, an effective listener is always attentive. That's why he's listening attentively, right? Effectively. Does not assume. So just in case, if you miss out on something, if some, like, for example, I'm speaking right now and maybe, see, we all are doing it virtually, right? We are not in a room sitting together. Then that is a different story. But now everybody has a family at their place and sometimes they're talking behind, right? So you tend to miss something and it is absolutely fine. But do not assume. Always ask. Okay? Do not assume that maybe she has said something about it. So the maybe should not be there. Okay? Ask. Do not assume anything. Listen for feelings and facts. As I told you, effective communication skills are something that would let you share your feelings and facts with the other person, right? And on the other hand, the other person is listening for that, right? So when you will be dealing with customers and with Monica, when she'll be dealing with employees, right? This is what you have to listen for, the feelings and facts, right? On board, customer will be coming up with a lot of complaints, and even on ground as well with the ground staff, right? If they are not happy with something, they'll come up to you and raise a complaint. They can be rude at times. Sometimes they are calmly telling you. So your job is to listen to them and acknowledge. All right. Always acknowledge that you are listening. And there are certain ways of acknowledging. You can acknowledge by words like, I understand. I know what you are talking about. Or I know where you are coming from. Right. But if the person is speaking continuously, do not interrupt by acknowledgement. Always acknowledge by your eyes and your, you know, nodding and body language. You can always nod along. Okay. One okay is perfectly fine. Okay. I understand is absolutely fine. And even nodding your head is absolutely fine. As long as that person is feeling that you guys are listening. Okay. Concentrate on the other speakers kindly and generously. So this point is when you are into a group discussion. And group discussions are a part of interview. in most of the airlines, right? So this is a part of the interview wherein they will make you sit in a group and they'll ask you to discuss on something, some topic, right? Now, you have to listen to everyone because it's a group discussion. And when you will be talking, they'll be listening to you, all right? Make sure that you will not interrupt anyone. Let them finish, let them tell their points, and then you can be prepared meanwhile with your points and information so that later on you can say it. You can say your statements, right? So always concentrate on other speakers and speakers kindly and generously. Give them time as much as they want, all right? Because nobody is, like, nobody will be in rush at that point of time. Interviewer will be judging you in on these parameters only, okay? Interviewer has nothing to do with the conclusion of the topic. Understand that. You don't have to actually conclude the topic. All you need to do is do the discussion and you are going to get judged on the discussion part, all right? Do not try to jump on the conclusion part, okay? Because this is something which is not necessary at all. But in MNC, if you're working in a multinational corporation, in like in any department, let's say, there you are having a team meeting wherein you need to discuss something. Now they're gonna judge you on the conclusion part. How much you're participating, how you're participating, if you're saying the valid points or not, and how are you concluding it, right? So this is, but you just need to, you first need to be the judge of your situation. If it is an interview or it is actual meeting in your company, all right? Now grab the opportunity. So when I said grab the opportunity, that doesn't mean that you have to snatch it from someone. It means you don't have to interrupt someone. Let him or her speak. But then if you have something to tell about, you need to grab the opportunity to say about the information that you have in your mind, right? Do not, like, if you get a pause, if you see that nobody's talking right now, you should be the one who grabbed the opportunity to talk about the discussion, to talk about the topic, right? Any doubts, any questions on that, guys?
Yeah, I have one question. Mm-hmm. In group discussion, they will give the topic, the team will choose that.
No, your interviewer will give you the topic.
Okay.
Yeah. So you're into...
Okay, then if somebody from the team if don't have any knowledge on that topic, then what?
Then this is what they wanna judge you about. Like, this is how they're gonna judge you. So you have to be prepared. I'll tell you how to get prepared for group discussion. All right. So it is like, what you can do is go through videos and, you know, you can check Google as well, like what are the topics that can be given in an interview. All right, mostly they are related to aviation, most of them, all right? But always check. But just in case, if you have done your homework and still you are unable to think anything about it, they don't care about the content. All they care is how you are delivering. Okay, so I'm not asking you to, like, do not make any sense over there, but just say anything that you know about it, anything that you can think of, all right? So this is something you need to figure out. This is the part of the interview, right? They want to see how much you can think about it and how you can deliver that the same, right? They will, trust me, they will not actually judge on the part, like, which candidate is speaking more or which candidate is talking more. They don't care about it. All they care about is how you are delivering your content, how you are talking. Are you interrupting people? Are you making negative body language? How are you accepting other points? How are you acknowledging? So there are a lot of parameters they will judge you on. And this is the last one, like, they will listen to the content and judge you on that, right? So even I have a presentation on group discussion. We'll let you know what are the rules and regulations, right, to do a group discussion, especially in an interview. Yes, Monica.
You can also listen to what others are speaking in case you are not aware with the topic, and then you can provide your point.
Exactly. What you can do is listen over here. Okay, you don't have to start right away. There's nobody asking you to initiate the conversation, right? If you do not understand the topic, you listen to people, frame your own sentence, right? Get something related to that and then talk about it, right? So this is what you can do if you are feeling complete alien about the topic, right? So this is what you can do over there. Any questions? Okay. So to conclude, effective listening enhances the communication quality. It encourages optimistic attitude, healthy relations, and more participation. It leads to better decision making in an organization. Effective listening is directly related to our ability to do teamwork. Right? Any doubts in that? So listening skills, to conclude, listening skills plays very important role when you are working with a team, when you are working in a team, right? And on board, you will be working with team. Even in a corporate, you'll be working with your team, right? So you need to listen to each one of them. You need to communicate effectively with each one of them. Otherwise, your company will have to bear the loss just because of you or your colleague, right? So make sure effective listening skills are taking place over there, right? Okay. Now, I have been talking about body language, right? So what do you think body language means?
Body language means non-verbal communication, like with hand gestures or face.
Right.
Sometimes eyes, head.
Absolutely.
Expression.
Expressions.
Physical emotions, maybe.
Sorry, Monica, didn't get you.
Like physical emotions.
So if you are, if you're feeling anything and it is getting on your face, then yes.
Yeah.
You know, you are stressed right now. You are angry on someone, right? And you are getting that expression on your face, then yes, people can see it. If you're grumpy, people can see it, right? And body language called nonverbal communication, right? And trust me, people will be able to understand you quickly by your body language. If you are a person who is interested in talking to someone, they will get to know. If you're a person who doesn't want to talk to anyone right now, they will get to know about it for sure with your body language, with help of your body language, right? Studies show that 70% of our communication is achieved non-verbally, and it is far more accurate than the words we use. Avoid words, it is words we use, all right? So non-verbally communication, which is far more accurate than the words that we are using, right, means your actions, right? Body language is your action that you are, putting in front of others, and they will be able to analyze it better than your words. Maybe you're just saying, you know, I'm fine. See, I'm saying I'm fine, but my expressions are so grumpy, right? So that this is how it plays a very, very important role. Now, we will be talking more about body language when you go for the interview or maybe you're working somewhere, right? So features of body language: posture, head motion, facial expression, eye contact, and gestures, all right? So posture means the way you are sitting, you're standing, you're walking. The way you are talking to someone, like if you were standing and talking to someone, what posture are you in at that point of time, right? Head motion. So Indians use a lot of head motions while talking, more than any nationality in the world, right? We have head motion for every feeling, I guess. If it is yes, if it is no, if it is this, whatever, right? So we are like using it a lot. Maybe other nationalities are not familiar with it. So yes and no is pretty much okay. But the way we do this is not actually, like other people, they don't know it. Other nationality, they're not aware of it, right? Like even for yes, we say like this. So avoid using it outside. Why? Because you know, Indians knows, your friends know about it, but other nationalities, they're not aware of this kind of nodding, right? So just make it a simple one. Yes or no is absolutely fine, okay? And if you speak, nothing better than that, right? So always give your answer by speaking and not a lot of nodding, right? Facial expression. But sometimes when you don't get a chance to speak, like when a customer is talking, not getting any chance, that time you can nod, you know, so that he can or she can know that you are listening, like kind of acknowledgement, right? Then facial expressions. Do not make your facial expressions in a way like, you know, negative kind of expressions, right? Should be neutral, I should say. If you are listening to someone, it should be neutral, okay? If you are happy, even if you're not happy, if you're just walking down the aisle on board, just make your facial expression kind of happy. You are approachable kind of expression. Like if someone have any questions, any doubt, or maybe just need something from on the plane, then they can approach you easily. Okay, facial expressions also play a very important role in an interview or in your professional life and even in your personal life. All right, eye contact. So when you are appearing for any interview and you are talking to the interviewer, make sure you are making an eye contact. Of course, you will be thinking about your answers, right? Little less in confidence. And this is absolutely fine. Everybody is, all right? And then maybe nervous, right? But do not start looking here and there, because we have habit of thinking and looking up. I think most of us, we have, right? Looking somewhere else and thinking. So we just need to avoid that while in the interview, while giving your interview. So always try to maintain that eye contact. Okay, do not make it uncomfortable for the other person, but suitable eye contact is absolutely fine. Right? Gestures. So there are a lot of gestures that doesn't look good when you're talking to someone. So one is like folded hands like this. See. So this is not a good gesture when you're talking to someone. All right? Especially professionally. Personally, you do whatever you want with your friends because they know you better than anyone else. Right? And they would not take it offensively. But professionally, people may. So do not fold your hands while talking to someone. Always use open hand gestures. And open hand gestures actually mean like you're open for the conversation. You're accepting the ideas. So like I'm teaching you here right now. Maybe you cannot see my hand. You cannot even see it. Still, I am moving here. Like, you know, something like this, that, right? So this is how you need to say. If not, then you can just keep your hand on your knees while you are sitting in front of the interviewer. Do not use hand gesture. All right? This is what you can do. Do not keep your finger locked in front of them on the table. Like in your... So do not lock your fingers on the table if you're sitting in front of an interviewer. But like if you're working somewhere, right, it's absolutely fine. So you need to be judge of your body language. You should know what is better at that point of time and what is not, right? So for an interview, just sit straight with your hands on your knees. One can be over on another one, or two hands like on both the knees, right? You can sit like that. Do not cross your legs. This is again not a very good position to sit in front of the interviewer especially, and even in the group discussion. So we have slides. Next slides will show you a lot of body languages, and you can easily figure out which one is appropriate and which one is not, right? See, a good posture. Everyone can see this is the poor posture, all right? It actually shows that you are very under confidence, right? Very nervous, cannot talk to anyone, introvert. Good posture, balanced, upright posture. And this is like your head is forward, this is like completely inappropriate, all right? So when you will be in that uniform of your cabin crew, always maintain that posture, high chin, not very up, but a little high, straight, right? Walking. So you have to maintain that, right? When you are walking anywhere at the airport, or if you are on your duty flights, as long as you're wearing the uniform, you have to maintain that posture throughout. And it is good to maintain if you are just hanging out socially. Do whatever you want to do at your place. Okay, I'm not gonna tell you about that. Okay, it's up to you. Of course, you need time to chill as well, like something that you feel like doing, do that. But when you are in your uniform, when you're working somewhere, then do maintain these postures. Maybe you are not aware of how you are walking and how you are standing, but other person can easily recognize, right? So if you see in this picture, you can easily make out which one is the appropriate posture to sit in. And this is how I mentioned, this is how I want you to sit in front of the interviewer. Like, you see the legs, you see the feet are connected, right, attached. And then she has maybe a resume in her hand. But when you'll be sitting, just keep your hand on your knees, okay, here. So she is actually waiting, which is, it is showing on her face that she is waiting. She is tired of waiting anymore for the interview. She's also tired, and she's also wondering when the turn will come. So when you go for the interview, they will be, you know, judging you on that. So there will be an interview walking all around the premises, checking how the candidates are doing. Are they sitting? Are they standing? Are they talking to each other? So they are actually judging you over there. Okay, so make sure when you're going for the interview, you maintain your body language throughout. It will be a long day for sure, all right? Maybe it will take a lot of time. Maybe you have come to the premises at 9 and you are still there at 7 p.m. in the evening. Still, you have to maintain that body language for that particular day. All right, yes, Monica.
Is it appropriate or is it okay to interact with other candidates when you Absolutely. Are waiting for the interview?
Absolutely, interact with them, and please get indulged in a positive conversation. Okay, do not start, I'm using this word, but do not bitch about different airlines over there. Okay, you don't know who is listening, right? Who is just standing right next to you. Maybe that person belongs to the hiring team, right?
Okay.
So always get indulged in a good conversation. Okay. You can get friends over there. You can become friends with someone over there. Then just mind your surroundings. Check your surroundings and indulge in a conversation accordingly. Okay. And it is absolutely fine to get into a conversation with someone who is also waiting for the interview.
Yeah.
Okay. Any questions in this? All good?
Yes.
Okay. If you see, a few people are standing and talking, and they're absolutely fine. So they are in an office right now. You know, they're just chit-chatting. And body languages of all of them are absolutely fine. Because they are not giving interview. They're already working. And still, all of them are looking approachable. Right? They are just maybe discussing or having to chat, not about the office, maybe about their personal lives, up to them. It's just that they're still maintaining that, right? Decorum in the office. Now, a lot of people are afraid of it, and this is what public speaking, right? You can improve that, or you can just get over your fear by practicing. Okay, so public speaking is one of the most important and most dreaded forms of communication, right? It's like you are standing over here and a lot of people just are your audience, and you have to speak in front of them. All right, in corporate world, public speaking is a vital skill to have, right? It affects simple everyday interaction between co-workers, bosses and employees, professionals and clients, and it can have an enormous impact on your career path and your level of success in the industry. Very well mentioned. If you are not afraid of speaking in front of public, if you can speak anywhere, right, it makes you more confident, right? Your co-workers, your boss and your clients will know you better, right? With good impact, right? And this will also help in your career to grow, right? Your career path and your level of success in the industry. This is why, you know, I want you guys to interact with people, because in your career, this is what you will be doing on daily basis. Be it cabin crew or be it an HR, right? So, speech anxiety or glossophobia, it's a most common fear people have across the globe. Sometimes, you know, people can interact well one-on-one, right? But they cannot speak in front of a lot of people. They cannot share their views and thought in front of a lot of people, but they are completely fine in talking with one person or two person at a time, right? But we need to get through this fear as well, all right? Why? I'm just talking about on board right now, the aviation part, and then I'll come up on the corporate part as well. So if you have seen, if you have flown with IndiGo, anyone, right? And you must have seen the cabin crew in charge always come in the middle of the aisle to give the welcome announcement. And this is just with IndiGo, as far as I know, all right? So she always come in the middle of the aisle just to give the welcome announcement, just to welcome all the passengers on board. She is doing public speaking over there, right? So this is one of the crucial things that you need to have if you are joining any airline, because you will be making a lot of announcements, right? And people will be looking at you, right? I have an activity as well. I have an announcement prepared wherein you have to look at it on the screen. You can take screenshot as well and you can prepare it. Okay, I'm not asking you to by heart and say it. Just look at it. You can read it through, but I just want to see the way you read it. All right. And even in corporate, sometimes an HR has to address a lot of employees at one point of time. I have worked in a corporate as well. All right. Of course, not as an HR, but as a travel advisor, I was there. Right. And I have seen HR addressing a lot of people at a time, right? Because maybe he or she has something important to convey, and it is very time consuming for him or her to do it one by one, right? There are a lot of HR policies changing, coming new, or maybe just getting updated. And it is a duty of an HR to convey to all of them. So sometimes, you know, what they do is they just call out a meeting all together and always talk about the new policies in front of them. And you should always be ready for the questions, right? A lot of people like me, of course, who do not understand much about HR policies will come up to you and ask questions over there, right? Same with the cabin crew. If you are making an announcement and you have mentioned the timing or something, but the passenger was aware of the duration, which is something else, right? So they can come up and ask question, what is the duration of the flight you mentioned? Because I thought it is 9 hours and you just said 9.5, right? So you should be there to rectify it over there. You know, you should be able to answer it, right? Okay. So now this slide is very important when you are having any conflict with your client. It could be a passenger, it could be an employee, and you are, let's say, a team leader, right? Or if you are a person who is actually responsible to answer them, we call it service recovery in aviation world, right? Service recovery as in something that someone has done wrongly, and now this person is coming up to you and asking for the resolution. Or maybe some mistake has been done by you. Or forget about the mistake. Maybe that person is just not happy with the policy. You cannot do anything about it, right? This is what something that you have been told by the company. You have to follow it, and the customer is not happy about it. Then who gonna take care of it? You. Again, listen actively. Active listening is everywhere, plays very important role everywhere, right? So if someone is complaining about it, listen to that person. Empathize. So what do we mean by empathize over here is, you always have to acknowledge that person that you understand what he is going through, right? It's like stepping in someone's shoes, which is actually not easy. Very easy to say, very hard to follow. But empathy is very, very important, just to make them aware that you are following them. You know what they are coming from, where they are coming from, right? Ask open-ended questions. So what are open-ended questions? Whose answer cannot should not be yes or no. Okay, there should be an answer for that, except for yes or no. Okay, do you like that? And the customer will say yes. Not this kind of question, but then as per the situation. Okay, could you please tell me whom did you speak to earlier? So this person will tell you an answer. You know, this cabin crew, I just spoke to this one. Okay, so could you please tell me, did you speak or have you get in touch with the ground staff? And if he or she said yes, then what did they say? You know, and then this person will tell you the whole statement, kind of that. And then paraphrase. So I have written points over here for you in my slides, but I'm paraphrasing also, right? I'm explaining. So what paraphrase means over here is, now you know the situation, now you know the concern, you have done the empathy part, you have asked questions, now you're paraphrasing. Okay, so just to make sure I got you correctly, you made a booking with us and then you forgot to book the wheelchair and ground staff did not help you with the same, right? So you have paraphrased everything because maybe that was the concern of the passenger. You know what, I was making booking and at the time of making my reservation, I forgot to book the wheelchair. And when I get to the airport, nobody helped me with that, blah, blah, blah. And then, you know, you are done with asking questions. And just in case if you don't have anything to ask, do not ask. It's not like it's a rule that you need to follow. This is just the part of it. You know, if you got everything correctly and if you don't have anything to ask, you can just quickly paraphrase. Okay, so if I got you correctly, you were trying to make a booking online, right? And you did not get the option to book wheelchair. And he'll be like, yeah. And nobody helped you on the ground, like the ground staff. So he'll be like, yeah, nobody did. Okay, I do apologize for that. I will raise it up to my supervisor, you know, like that. And we'll make sure it will not happen in future. You know, and then you can always give them resolution, what they can do next time. You know, always give them solution for the next time. What you can do is always call our customer care number to check if wheelchair is booked for you or not, so that you don't have to go through the same problem. We'll make sure that you don't have to, but this is what you can do from your end, right? So always give that person solution that he can do in future, and always make sure or always reassure that it will not be repeated with us, and you will take care of it by informing the concern authorities. Can be ground staff, can be your supervisor. Your supervisor can convey, right? Any question in that? So we call it LEAP, L-E-A-P, right? Listen actively, empathize, ask open-ended question and paraphrase, and you are good to go, right? Any questions, anything you need to add, please feel free. All good, okay. So, we are done with the communication part, right? Now, as I mentioned, I have an activity of public speaking for you, all right? And we'll be practicing public speaking.